Hello, hello. Thanks for tuning in. Today I wanted to show you how important it is to be able to adjust your solar panels to the changing season and climate around you. So I have a little test set up here in a tiny home. We got a load coming on right now. So we're keeping the battery in a slight state of discharge to show how much solar we're actually getting in. And you see we're at 12.5. 253, we're charging at 14 amps. So we can come over and verify here. We are bringing in 12.8 volts at 177 watts with 13.8 amps. We are charging a 100 amp hour battery down there. And if you guys want to know anything more about this little setup, just go ahead and drop a comment below and I'll do an individual video on them if you just specify what you want to know. So you see there under load, we're pulling in 177 watts. I'm gonna go outside and show you guys. We're in the first week of December and the panels have been just kind of mounted on the contour of the roof. That is the best for the summer out here. It's 15 minutes to noon, so the sun is real high in the sky for winter time. And I'll show you how the panels are laying right now. So as you can see, clear skies, sun is out. And if you look at the panels, they're kind of just mounted flat on there. We were at 177 watts coming in. We're going to go ahead and adjust two of those panels. Now, these are the Harbor Freight panels, the old and the new ones mixed. So the old ones in the back, they do provide some power. It's not great, but we'll see the difference of just angling the new panels. All right, as you can see, they are tilted pretty far up. I slid them down so they wouldn't be blocking the other panels. So remember, we're at 177, so let's go in there and see what we got. All right, we're back inside. Same test parameters, got a heater pulling a load on there. You see we got more amperage coming in now, 16.2. And we're at about 189, 190 watts, 14.5 amps. So the amperage and the wattage went up about 10 watts, 11 watts, and another amp or so up. So it's showing you that angling it does help. So we'll go ahead and wipe them off and see if we get anything better. And we're sitting at around 188, 189, 187, so 10 watts over with the angling. Okay, we cleaned the panels up there with some ammonia free glass cleaner and it looks like we gained another watt or two and a few points, a few tenths on the amp. So we tilted it and cleaned it. Now let's see what the no load is. Now this is just straight charging the batteries. Now remember, we started at about 177 watts before we did anything. And we can see the batteries charging up, 16.5 amps or so. So we'll see what it peaks out at and come back. If the video quality looks a little different, sorry, I had to switch cameras. The other memory card was full. So battery voltage is 13.8, 0.9, almost 16 amps coming in. And as you can see here, 224 watts at 15.65 amps. So it's pulling in the power now. And we'll see if it gets any higher and then we'll pull a load again. Okay, we're sitting at about 14.3 volts. Yeah, 14.3 and about 15.5 amps. See the battery's getting 223 watts there. It's 100 amp hour battery. We are coming through the Renogy Wanderer PWM charge controller. And we're seeing a max of about some clouds passing over. 15.8 amps. And 226.9, so we'll call it 227 watts. So at least a 50 watt gain by angling and cleaning the panels. That's pretty good. I'm gonna put it back under load and see what happens.
right, we're back under load. So 225 amps. We are drawing the battery down, as you can see. We'll see what it drops to under load again. So we started out with around 177, I believe. So 16.3 amps is what's going into the battery right now. Got it coming out of a pure sine wave inverter, 100 amp hour battery, into a 400 watt heater on high. Let it pick back up and see where it levels out. And then we're back over 200 watts again. So yeah, with a little bit of angling, a little bit of time, a little bit of wipe down cleaning, you can definitely achieve more wattage in your panels. You see here, we're getting about 50 more watts in. So yeah, with the change of every season, if you can angle your solar panels and wipe them down, I clearly think that it's a definite help. Getting over 50 watts more into the batteries, more wattage, more amperage, means faster charging to the battery. So I hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.